Jeff's Magic Hook. Jeff walked into the kitchen and saw his mom preparing a big red fish for dinner.
We at UNICEF have been very privileged to be exposed to this concept and this project of the talking books that was introduced to us by USP, where they brought the sample of the work that they have been doing. But what really attracted us to this project was when they used actually the books that UNICEF had been producing for Solomon Islands and Vanuatu and Fiji, and taking one of the books and actually implementing it and using the software that they have and demonstrating to us how it can be used in the communities and with the families and with the children. UNICEF had been producing these children's books as part of our early childhood development program, where we wanted, based on our knowledge, attitude, and practice study that we had conducted, where we noticed that there was a huge gap within families where they did not have any access to any kind of appropriate children's books or any kind of print materials that was appropriate for young children. And that triggered the development of these locally made children's story books that we used as an entry point for our parenting education program and distribution of the books to the parents. So the talking books was really a timely intervention where it would help us to increase the access of these books to a larger number of families who can use either their mobile phones or tablets or computers or whatever that they have. In our case, once I got the sample of the book on my own phone, it was very good for me because as I traveled to the field, especially in Solomon Islands, I managed to show it to the parents, I managed to show it to the teachers, to the community workers that we are working with, and they were all received with a huge reception of we want it. The workshop was also as an extension of this whole project of the talking books, which not only it looked at basically increasing the capacity of those who are engaged in media and also writing and producing children's books to be able to use a new tool and a new app to use their own talents in producing more children's books that can make it more accessible to the children and the families. And I think the concept of being able to share the materials produced as a result of now this capacity that has been built in terms of how to use the app and how to produce, you know, your own homegrown books will really address one of the biggest gaps that the Pacific is having regarding access to children's books and will make this much more accessible. And it's again something that we would encourage much and we'd like to see it happening more often. So we are happy that the two-day workshop with the facilitation by Kun that did that. I know that our team that went there came back very, very enthusiastic and came up with a whole host of ideas of how this can be used to make it more accessible also. And I think it's very useful for people with disabilities as well, because you will have the print. If you cannot hear it, you still can see it, and it has that element of interaction that can be used.